Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. I'm Sharmin. Today I'm gonna teach you adaptations of rice for wet environment. Okay, so let's get started. Although rice can grow in dry conditions, it's often grown in paddy field where the ground is intentionally flooded. Okay, and rice can tolerate growing in water where most of the weeds that might compete with it are not able to do so. And most plants can't grow in deep water because their roots don't get enough oxygen. And oxygen is required for aerobic respiration, which provides ATP as an energy source for active transport and other energy consuming processes such as cell division. Nor if the leaves are submerged can photosynthesis take place because there is not enough carbon dioxide available. Happens because gases diffuse much more slowly in water than they do in air. Okay, and moreover, the concentration of dissolved oxygen and carbon dioxide in water are much less than they are in air, and this is especially true in air paddies where the rich mud is the rice roots are planted contains large populations of microorganisms, and many of which are aerobic and take oxygen from the water. Okay, so yeah. Some varieties of rice respond to flooding by growing taller, okay? And as the water rises around them, they keep growing upwards so that the top parts of their leaves and flower spikes are always held above the water. And this allows oxygen and carbon dioxide to be exchanged through the stomata on the leaves. And the stems of the rice plants contain loosely packed cells forming a tissue known as parenchyma, and gases are able to diffuse through the parenchyma to other parts of the plant, including those under the water. And this is supplemented by air that is trapped in between the ridges of the underwater leaves, and these leaves have a hydrophobic corrugated surface that holds a thin layer of air in contact with the leaf surface. And nevertheless, the cells in the submerged roots do still have to use alcoholic fermentation at least some of the time, and ethanol can therefore build up in the tissues. And ethanol is toxic, but the cells in rice roots can tolerate much higher levels than most plants. Okay, so yeah, and they also produce more alcohol dehydrogenase, and this breaks down ethanol, and this allows the plants to grow actively even when oxygen is scarce, and using ATP produced by alcoholic fermentation. So guys, that's all. Thank you for watching.